We have a daughter who has special needs. Since then, everything's been different for sure.
I think we were winging it, weren't we? She has a very rare syndrome called Costello syndrome. She's one of five or six people in Alberta that we know of that has it. And when she was diagnosed, we were told 300 people worldwide.
Allie had such a hard time, so she couldn't actually eat or swallow when we first had her. So she had a tube down her nose when we first brought her home, and we had a feeding pump, which basically ran 24/7 just to get enough food into her so that she wouldn't throw it all back up. And the neighbors would invite us to come over to do something, and I just remember them coming over, and I had to get Tyler Robinson, the fire chief. He come over and he's helping me with this pole and this thing, and we're carrying it down the driveway in the
You're
snow,
like,
and
don't jiggle her, don't
then come
jiggle her.
back with the kid in the car seat, and then go over there, and then we went over to some other friends, kind of the same thing in their basement, watching Grey Cup.
Allie basically had to just be left alone, and she was sick all the time, and she was grumpy, and it was all we could do for the first few years to get Allie everything she needed. And I think Maddie, she got what she needed, but she didn't always get a lot. So we try very hard to make sure that they both get what they need, even though sometimes we're spread pretty thin. Maddie is so good with Allie. She makes a lot of sacrifices for her sister. She doesn't question it. She's starting to have a life of her own now because she's 13. She loves playing sports, so she plays on a lot of school teams, and she likes going out with her friends, but when she's at home with her sister, she plays with her and she talks to her, and they're siblings, so they fight and they argue. But Maddie is really great with her sister. She actually won a sibling champion award for being a good advocate for her sister and for acting as a bridge between her sister and the community. I have no complaints about her. One big thing we've learned is that hearing that news about your child that they have extra needs is devastating. You have to let yourself feel that, let yourself grieve, and let yourself be devastated. But then over time, you learn to value the small milestones. You learn so many valuable things along that journey. Allow yourself to grieve, but still look forward to the future. And, even though a little bit of you is prepared for the worst, you have to hope for the best and, work for it.
We struggle for sure.
We do.
It is
We
an
do.
endless maddening
Yeah,
cycle.
it's not an easy journey,
As
but
we
we've
look at
learned to
the
take it one day at a time.
as we look at the clock and it's 9:30 and we're like, oh, it's time for bed, I guess.